Today I fucked up by playing a gross joke on my wife. I posted last night in AskReddit, and this morning I was asked via PM to post it here as well. I'm not sure if it's actually appropriate for this subreddit, as today was actually about 12 years ago. But, yes, it was indeed a fuck up. Mods, please delete if it doesn't fit. Anyway, on to a look into one of my numerous dumbass hijinks. My wife and I used to belong to the House Rabbit Society, meaning we had cage-free rabbits as pets. We were taught that if dry alfalfa grass was placed into a cat litter box that was lined with paper, we used shredded paper, that they would go potty in the box. The grass there is a distracting snack. Yeah, no, they shit all over the floor, and couch, and bed, and... Anyway, I couldn't help but notice one evening that a rabbit turd looks quite a lot like a raisin. Well, we've always kept raisins in the dry pantry. 2 plus 2 equals hilarious prank, right? I grabbed a lone raisin out of a box, and walked into the room my wife was in. I calmly pretended to pick up a bunny turd off the floor, and pretended to put it in my mouth. My wife says, "Oh yeah, right." What she didn't know is through sleight of hand, I'd put a raisin in my mouth. Stuck out my tongue at her, showing her I was indeed eating a rabbit poop. She started vomiting all over the carpet, leaving a rancid trail to the hallway bathroom, and then in the toilet. She refused to listen to me, as she was too busy throwing up and violently crying. I finally got her calmed down, and explained. She refused to kiss me for about a solid 24 hours, and threw up again later when she reimagined it. Too long didn't read, I pretended to eat rabbit poop as a joke. Wife showed her appreciation by throwing up all over the floor and refusing to even kiss me for an entire day. Damn, she got a weak ass stomach, lol. I guess that turned out to be a real shitty joke. Smile. Hello fellow rabbit keeper. This post gave me some comfort somehow. One of my rabbits died unexpectedly a while ago and this post helped me get over it a little more. Hey dude slash dudette, I am very sorry to hear that, but I am glad that, in its own way, this provided some comfort during a hard time. That's a great one for parties. You know, actually I once pretended to shove a pocky down my throat, and my NB friend started crying. I felt so bad. Please forgive my ignorance, but I don't know what pocky or NB friend mean. Yeah, I felt about yay big after my little stunt. We have rabbits too. They are litter box trained, but once there was a whole peppercorn on my husband's plate when we had company over for dinner. I saw it and lost all appetite and even had to ask what it was. He and company found it hilarious. I thought there was a rabbit poop just chilling on his plate. Today I fucked up by staring at my boss's mother's ass. I work for a small company owned by the most wholesome family I have ever met. Honestly, they are so wholesome and nice that I think they have a dirty secret because they are all just that nice. No one is that nice, but they really are, or maybe not. Dot. Back to the FU. While I was waiting for my coffee to finish brewing, I was looking through the large window about 15 feet away from me, watching these roofers working on the building across the street from us. These guys were absolutely incredible, slapping roof shingles down at a speed I've never seen before. One guy is at the ridge of the roof sliding shingles down like a blackjack dealer to the two guys below. Two guys catch the shingles, align them, and nail them down all in one swift motion. There was no wasted time and I was truly amazed at the efficiency of their process. I probably watched them for 10 minutes. While I'm watching these impressive roofers, my boss's angel of a mother is doing some cleaning in the office, directly in my line of sight but below the roofers that I was watching. My boss B sees me, clears his throat to get my attention, and says in an irritated voice, "B, what are looking you at?" Me points arm in direction of roofers backslash B. Puzzled look backslash "What the hell is wrong with you?" Me, "Look, boss. That's incredible. I've never seen anything like that." B, "Are you sick in the head or something?" Confused, I look at him, then back at the roofers, then back at him, then back to the roofers again. I avert my gaze away from the roofers and look slightly down. What I see is his 75-year mother on all fours, her thick rumpus flying high in the air aimed directly at me, polishing the base of our wooden conference table. She hears her son, turns her head towards me and gives me a look of pure disappointment that only a grandmother can give when you tell her you aren't hungry. QFU alarm blaring at full blast in my head. Me, OMG boss, no. X1000. I'm watching those roofers over there. Boss steps out of his office, looks out the window, and sees the roofers that were previously out of his vantage point. Deep sigh of relief from him. He looks at me, says, oh wow, those guys really are incredible. Sorry about that. He awkwardly chuckles. I awkwardly chuckle. His mother keeps polishing away and I avoid eye contact with her for the rest of the day. Too long didn't read, was watching efficient roofers across the street. Boss thought I was staring at his elderly mother's fat freak in pooper cheeks. What? You should have told the boss his assumption was right. That'd be the ultimate power move and he'd just have to make you the new boss. Look at me, I am the daddy now. Props to boss for being able to admit a mistake was made. I was literally crying out of depression and this made my day. Thank you. As I stared, I slowly shook my head and muttered under my breath, just hammering away. Dot. Boss's mother's ass. Today I fucked up by playing Animal Crossing and smoking weed. This has been happening over the last couple months, since the new Animal Crossing came out, and I just noticed last night, but was too stoned to post also, on mobile, so excuse the formatting. I have been working during quarantine so I haven't had a lot of time to play. My evening routine is usually come home, grab my Switch and my bong, I live in a non-smoking apartment, and sit on the porch and play Animal Crossing while I smoke. When I get to a loading screen, I will usually set my Switch down, take a hit, and by the time I set my bong back down, the game is finished loading. The timing is perfect. So last night, I was playing later than normal. I was sitting inside with my boyfriend, already sufficiently high. I run inside a villager's house, set my Switch on my lap, like usual, and reach next to me, to the arm of the couch. And I just look in horror and go, oh no. My boyfriend looks at me and goes, what's wrong? I look at him and go, I've conditioned myself to want weed every time I see the loading screen. He just starting laughing and eventually calmed down enough to say, you Pavloved yourself. Too long didn't read, I accidentally conditioned myself over the last few months to take a hit every time I see the Animal Crossing loading screen on my Switch. Can't wait for the future when your villagers will talk about this due to advanced scripts. And this is how addiction happens without chemical dependency. 10/10 I do the same thing with games I play, haha. I think you meant to post this in r/life pro tips. I drink Coke every time I see scorpions in Combat League. You must have no teeth left then. This is the same for me in pretty much any video game.